Dear students, now we are going to discuss frequency allocation for satellite services. Whenever we are talking about satellite services, we have to consider the entire world. Since it requires international coordination and planning, it is a complicated process to allocate frequencies to all satellite services. So here we have to consider the international coordination and planning. So it can be done under the guidance of International Telecommunication Union, simply ITU. Okay, there are various frequency bands available for satellite services. It is in the range of gigahertz. So it can be named for each range. So here 0.1 to 0.3 gigahertz is designated as VHF band. That is very high frequency band. 0.3 to 1.0 as UHF, 1 to 2 as L band, 2 to 4 gigahertz as S band, 4 to 8 as C band, 8 to 12 as X band, 12 to 18 as KU band, 18 to 27 as K band, 27 to 40 gigahertz as Ka band, 40 to 75 as B band, 75 to 110 gigahertz as W band. So here 110 to 300 as mm band, that means millimeter waves, because its wavelength is in the range of millimeter. So here 300 to 3000, it is in the range of micrometer. Do you all understand this? In order to allocate frequencies for various satellite services, the world is divided into three regions: region 1, region 2 and region 3. Europe, Africa, formerly the Soviet Union, and Mongolia are coming under Region 1. North and South America and Greenland are grouping as Region 2. Asia, excluding the Region 1, Australia and Southwest Pacific are grouping as Region 3. So within these regions, the frequency bands are allocated to various satellite services. So there are different satellite services available. So major 5 services are listed here: fixed satellite service, broadcasting satellite service, mobile satellite service, navigational satellite service, meteorological satellite service. So first one is fixed satellite service. This fixed satellite service is mainly used to provide the link for existing telephone system and also for cable network. So mainly for telephone and cable companies. So here C band is used for this fixed satellite service. Here the sub range is 4 to 6 gigahertz, that is 6 by 4 gigahertz. Here 6 is the uplink frequency, 4 is the downlink frequency. Okay, next one is broadcasting satellite service, simply BSS. It is mainly used for direct broadcast to the home. Example, direct broadcast satellite, that is DBS, or direct to home DTH in European countries. So here Q band, that is KU band, is widely used for this DBS service. Its range is 14 to 12 gigahertz. That means uplink frequency is 14, downlink frequency is 12 gigahertz. Okay. So the next one is mobile satellite service. It is mainly used for land mobile, maritime mobile, that is in ship we can use the service, and aeronautical mobile. L band is used for mobile satellite services and for navigation services. So next one is navigational satellite service. It is mainly used for global positioning system concept. So L band as well as VHF is also used for certain navigations. Okay. So the last one is meteorological satellite service. It is mainly used for search and rescue service. Here VHF band is used for data transfer. Okay, do you all understand that?